Hi. Let us solve the next problem. So this is called edit distance. And basically, you're given two strings and you're supposed to compute the minimum number of operations required to transform one string to the other. So they defined the allowed operations, which are to add a character to any of the strings, to remove a character from any of the strings, or to replace one character for the other. All right, so they give an example right here, which we're going to look at. So your input would just be the two strings, and your output would be a number representing the minimum number of edits required to convert one string to the other. So let's take a look at this example and see what they did. So if you wanted to convert this string, you wanted to make these two strings equivalent, well, you could replace this L, you could just replace this with M, all right? That is one operation. And you could add I somewhere here. That is your second operation. So that indeed takes two operations to make these two strings equivalent. Now, if you've never seen this problem before, or you've never encountered the technique I'm about to show you, you might find this particular question quite challenging to solve. Or you might come up with a solution, but it's going to take a really long time to run. So let's start by looking at the time, the constraints we are given. As you can see, the size of the string could be as big as 5,000 characters. So what that tells you at least is that we can actually have an algorithm with a big O of n squared. Okay, so that should be sufficient just by looking at the constraints. So what we're going to do basically is to build our solution step by step, starting from empty strings and work our way up to the two strings we are given. All right, so I've drawn the table and you're going to see how we compute our answer. So this right here means an empty string for both. And each cell in this grid represents the minimum edit distance required to convert the two strings at that particular point. So for this cell right here, all you need to do is trace it down and then take this string. So you're basically comparing the two strings you are given, love versus movie, and you want to convert one to the other. All right. But if I choose a different cell, if I choose this cell, for example, what that tells you is we are comparing this and this, okay? So we are trying to find the minimum number of operations required to make these two strings equivalent. So that's how to interpret what the individual cells represents. Now let's talk about how to fill the cells. But before we do, observe that these two operations are equivalent. All right, so we can just choose one. We're going to go with removing a character. So let me explain what I mean by they're equivalent. Let's say you had string A as A, B, and you had the second string as just A, all right? So if you wanted to make these two strings the same, you have two options, all right? You could add a character here and they will become the same. Or you could remove this, all right? Both operations will cost just one and they are equivalent. So you could choose to go with either of them, you're still going to get your minimum edit distance. All right, now let's talk about how to compute the answer. So at any point in time, we're going to do either of three things. All right, so the first thing we're going to do, let's say you are at this point, okay? Let's label the squares around this particular block. So we have A, B, C, okay? So for this square, we are basically comparing move with LO. So we're comparing this with this, all right? Now, if we decide to remove this character, if we decide to remove this character L, then all we have to do is take a look at the value we computed here and add one to it, okay? So that's the meaning of removing the character of the first string. If we decide to remove the character of the second string, that's V, if we decide to remove this, then we need to take a look at the value we computed here and add one to it, all right? Now, if we decide to replace one character for the other, then we're going to take a look at the value here and add one to it. All right, so those are the three operations if the two characters we are comparing are not equal. And the reason for that is, let's say you are here, you are at this point C, okay? So for that, you're going to get MO versus LO, okay? And as you can see, we've basically removed the character V in this equation. So at this point, you've removed the character V. If you are to add V, that means you've expanded one operation. So that is the meaning. So there's one more thing you want to take note of, and that is that if the two characters are the same, so maybe at this point, if the two characters are the same, then all you have to do is bring down the value you had at this point. So go diagonally and break down whatever value you had at that point. And once again, let's look at why that is the case. So you have, at this point, you're comparing LO with MO. Okay? Since these two characters are the same, you don't really need to do anything. All right? So because you don't need to do anything, it's basically the same as saying, okay, what is the edit distance when we've not added these characters? All right? So give me the edit distance to get to that point. And that's equivalent to comparing just L and M. And that square is when you go one step diagonally. That's where you get to that particular square. So those are the main ideas I wanted to mention before we proceed. Now let us fill the table, and this is going to be a lot clearer. All right, so for this should be zero because we're comparing two empty strings that are equivalent. So we don't really need to perform any operation. We're going to first fill the first row. Okay, this should be one. So you're comparing an empty character with the word L. So what you could do is just remove L and you get one operation. So following that logic, this should be two, this should be three, and this should be four. Again, what that implies is that at this square, you're comparing an empty character with the word love, okay? So to get these two to be equivalent, you could just remove each of these characters to get an empty string, and that will cost you four operations. So that's what we have for right here. All right, let us proceed. I think things will get interesting from the second row. Okay, at this point, you're going to bring down whatever you have up and add one to it, okay? Because you're comparing an empty character, you're comparing M with an empty character. So you just remove M to get your answer. Now, for this square, what you're going to do is, like I mentioned, you consider those three operations. Since M is not the same as L, okay? So we consider those three operations. One would be to remove L, at which point we just add 1 to whatever we have at this, on this square to the left. The other option we have is to remove M. So we add 1 to what we have above this square. And then the last option we have is to replace a character. So what to do that, you go diagonal and add 1 to whatever we have this here. So in this case, the best result will be the minimum number you get by performing any of those three operations. So, and that would be 0 plus 1. So the answer to this is 1. Basically, we've chosen to replace a character. And to understand what that is saying is this versus L, we could just simply replace this with M using a single operation to get our answer. So that's how that is done. Now we are at this square, okay? So a shortcut would be, look at all these three numbers that are adjacent to this square, and then pick the minimum and add 1 to it, okay? So the minimum is 1, add 1 to it, and you're going to get 2. So that's that. So this is 2. The same thing here. 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So we're done filling that square. For here, we have 0 compared to an empty square. So you bring down this and add 1 to it, so you have 2. At this point, you look at all those squares adjacent to it and add 1 to it, and you have 2. Okay? Now, we're comparing the characters O with O. And like I mentioned, what you need to do is bring down what you have in the diagonal square. So you're going to bring down 1 here, and that will be your answer. Just like I've explained, you have two characters, LO versus MO. Because these two are the same, you could just remove them and say, okay, what is the best you've done if you don't have those two characters in the strings? So that's the idea, and the answer is 1. So for this, you do the same. You look at those three adjacent squares and pick the minimum, then add 1 to it. So 1 plus 1 should give you 2 as the answer here. So just to clarify, if you have love and MO, so you need two operations to convert those characters, and you do that by, I guess, removing V and then replacing this with M. All right, so here you're comparing the character O with E. So they're not the same. So you look at those three adjacent squares, pick the minimum and add 1 to it, and the answer to this will be 3. All right, let's quickly fill the next row. So this should be 2 plus 1. 3. This should be 2 plus 1, 3. This should be 1 plus 1, 2. So this should be 1 plus 1. So you're choosing to replace a character here. So 1 plus 1 will give you 2. So let's just quickly look at this example again. So at this point, you have LOV versus MOV. Okay. Now, because V and V are the same, this is actually not correct. Because V and V are the same, you're going to go back and then choose, bring down whatever you have in this diagonal. So you're going to have 1, right? So basically, if the V's were not there, what would you get? And the answer is 1. All right, so at this point, you look at those three values and add 1 to it. So 1 plus 1 will give you 2. Okay, let's keep going. This is 4. This is 3 plus 1, which is 4. This is 2 plus 1, 3. Look at this. The minimum is 1. You add 1 to it, you get 2. And at this point, you're going to add 1 to this to get 2 once again. So quickly, what that tells you is if you had, if you're comparing L-O-V-E with M-O-V-I, okay, if you're comparing those two characters, your best move is to first check the minimum edit operations required to get to this, and then you replace one kind of character for the other. So you can replace this with I, and you're done. So this would cost you one operation plus the operation you need to get to this value right here, and that would be, if you look at, that would be this right here, and the answer to that is 1. So that's why I had 1 plus 1 to get 2 right here. All right, so let's keep going. Let's do the last row. So for this, you add 1 to what you had above to get 5. You look at those three adjacent squares, and then you add 1 to it. Get the minimum and add 1 to it. So you have 5 here. So 3 plus 1 is 4. 2 plus 1 is 3. And finally, you have the characters that are equivalent. You have E and you have E. All right? So like I mentioned, you bring down what you had in the diagonal square, and that will give you 2. So your final answer is going to be whatever you have in the bottom right square, and that will be 2. If you look at the question, you can see our output is 2. So that's how you can solve this. And obviously, the time complexity is going to be bigger of n times m time, where n is the size of the first string and m is the size of the second string. Now for the space could be bigger of n times m space if you decide to build the entire DP table using a grid, okay? If you decide to compute the entire grid, but just like I've said before, you don't need to do that. At any particular row, all you need is the previous row to compute that row completely. So you don't need to go beyond the previous row. And that's why in the implementation, which we're going to see next, we're just going to keep two DP tables. One will be the previous computation, and then we have the DP table we are currently computing. Okay, so with those two, we can actually find our answer without having to keep track of the entire matrix. So the space for our own version of the code would be 2m. You can drop the constant, and then you have just big of m space. All right, so with that, pause the video and try to implement this yourself. I'm going to do that next. All right, so what we're going to do is print the input. Then we're going to build the DP table and print out the results. Actually, this is broken down into, we're going to initialize the DP tables. Okay, like I mentioned, we're going to have two, priv and the current one. And we're going to make sure the first row is set. Then finally, we're going to build the DP table and print our answer. So let's start with the first step, which is to read the input. So that's the input. We just read that. Next step will be to have those two tables I mentioned. So let's define this integer n as the size of the first word. Okay, and then let us initialize the first row, which represents a comparison between an empty string and the first string we are given, so word one. So for okay, so that's for that. That's for our first row. Next, we're going to loop through each character of the second word. And for each character, we're going to compute the DP table for that particular row. Okay, so that's what we're going to do next. So like I mentioned, for at the very first cell, you bring down whatever you had above and add one to it, because you're comparing this with an empty string, and you can only get them to be the same by removing those characters. Next, we're going to loop from I equals to 1, and we compare the two characters and see what we get. So the first thing we want to do is if they are equivalent. So for example, if this is the same as this, then you bring down what you computed for the previous comparison, okay? So O is the same as O, then you go diagonally and bring down whatever you have in that square. And I've explained the reason why. Once you've done that, you can continue. Now, if they are not the same, okay, if they're not the same, for example, you are here, then you're going to look at all adjacent squares, the three adjacent squares, pick the minimum and add one to it. So another way to look at it is, let's say you wanted to remove the first character from the first word. If you wanted to remove a character from the first word, what that means is you go up and add one to it. So that will take one operation. You could also remove a character from the second word. So for that, you go to your left and add one to it. All right. Now the third operation you could do is to replace one character for the other. It doesn't matter which one, they are the same. It's basically an equivalent operation. So for that, if you're going to replace, then you're going to go look at the diagonal cell and add one to it. So that's the same as saying priv I minus 1 plus 1. Okay. So choose the minimum of those three operations, and then that will be your answer for that DP. So the minimum of either replacing or removing a character. Okay. So once we are done computing a row, we then that row becomes the previous. All right, and we can then fill our DP table with zeros and proceed with the next row. So that's it. Once you're done with this, you can then print out your answer, which should be the last item in the table. All right, let's try this out with the example they gave. So that gives 2, just like we expected. Let's try comparing LO with MO and see what that gives. So that gives 1, as we expect. Let's try this square right here. So L with MOVI. So let's try that. So that gives us 4. And finally, let's just try LOV with M with movie. That should give us 3. Yep. So I think this looks good. I'm going to try to submit. All right, so that got accepted.